Here I'm asked to solve a quadratic inequality. In other words, I'm asked to find the x values I can plug in here so that this expression is greater than 0. Well, the first thing I notice is that this trinomial here factors. So I can write the equivalent inequality in factored form. So 5 is 1 times 5. 1 and 5 add up to negative 6 if they're both negative. And then a negative 1 times a negative 5 is positive 5. The first step in the process is to find the critical values. Now, the critical values are the real numbers where this expression changes from positive to negative or negative to positive. For a quadratic, the critical values are the zeros. So, what values make this equal to 0? Since it's factored, you can easily see 1 will make it equal to 0, and 5 will make it equal to 0. Okay, so the critical values here are 1 and 5. The second step in the process is to make a sign chart. Now the sign chart is just a quick and easy way to get a picture of what the graph would be. This is a parabola if I were to graph this up. Okay, so let's choose a good scale. Let's make sure we get 5 in there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And since we're dealing with a strict inequality, there's no equal sign, I'm going to use an open dot at the critical value 1. And an open dot at the critical value 5. This breaks the number line up into three regions: the right side, the middle, and the left side. Now, to make a sign chart, you want to determine if the sign in that region is positive or negative. To do that, you choose a test value. So in this region, I'm going to choose a test value of 10. You could choose any number you want in that region, doesn't matter. When x is 10, I'm going to look at this form. 10 minus 1 is 9. And then when x is 10 here, 10 minus 5 is 5. 9 times 5 is 45. I don't really care what the number is. I just care that it's greater than 0. In fact, any number you choose in that region, you will get a positive answer. Okay, let's choose a test value in the middle region here, say 3. Like I said, I don't really care what the number is, so we're worried about the sign. 3 minus 1 is 2, and that's positive. 3 minus 5 is negative 2, and that's negative. Okay, a positive times a negative will always be negative, so any number you choose in that region, plug it in, you'll have a negative answer. Okay, and then in the left region over here, let's choose, say, negative 10. When I substitute in negative 10, minus 1 is negative. Don't really care what the number is. Negative 10 minus 5 is negative 15, so that's negative as well. And then so a negative times a negative is positive. So in that region, any number you choose, the result would be positive. So here's the rough sketch of the graph. This is a parabola opening up, and you can see it would look something like this. It's above the x-axis when x is less than 1 or greater than 5. Okay, the third step is to answer the question. Now, to answer the question, well, the question is, when is this expression greater than 0? Greater than 0 means positive. So we're going to use our sign chart and shade in all the x values that give me positive results. So I'm shading in all those x values and also all of these answers here for x. Choose any x value in these regions and plug them in, and that result will be greater than 0. Okay, so that's my answer expressed graphically on a number line. Now we have to convert that into interval notation. So for this interval, I'm going to write that as negative infinity up to 1, non-inclusive, so we'll use a regular parentheses, union 5 out to infinity. Okay, so this is my answer expressed in interval notation. Infinitely many solutions to this quadratic inequality.